Hello and welcome, this is Stefan from REDcatch. In this video I would like to show you how to use a smartphone RTK system to receive accurate GNSS signals in combination with GIS software for digitizing in-field data. I will use a smartphone connected to GNSS hardware to get the location of objects from the real world into my computer. To demonstrate this, I have a couple of objects next to my office, such as these manholes, a construction site, and a street island. I would like to locate these accurately and digitize them into my GIS software. To get a quick overview, I will explain the components I use. So, first of all, I will need an antenna to get my location from GNSS satellites. This antenna is connected to my RTK device, which is then connected to my smartphone. On the phone, I use the REDcatch app to dial into my NTRIP provider. This allows me to receive an additional signal from a reference network and get a corrected GNSS position with about 1 to 2 cm accuracy. On my mobile phone, I will use the QField app as well to collect and save the field data. And for the office work, I use the free open source software QGIS on my PC to establish projects and manage the collected field data. To use GIS and collect data in the field, it is necessary to prepare the data and create a GIS project on my computer first, which then will be transferred to the mobile device for field data collection. So I open QGIS and create a new project with a base layer and a point feature shapefile in it. In the shapefile, I add some fields as well to save relevant information such as name, photos, and coordinate values to features once I'm in the field collecting data. I also used some basic codes as default values to auto-generate the coordinates for my new features in the field. Once I'm happy with the information I added, I save the project and transfer the data to my mobile device using the QField Sync plugin. Once I transfer the GIS data to my mobile device, I can finally go outside and prepare the components to start digitizing. So, with a cable, I connect the antenna and the RTK device together. And the RTK device also has to be connected to my phone. Now I can already start with the data transfer. After installing the REDcatch 4D app, I connect to the GNSS antenna via Bluetooth and dial into the NTRIP client. The system should now be ready to start receiving accurate GNSS location. After installing the QField app from the Google Play Store, I start the app and open the project which I established on the computer. With the NTRIP client running in the background and the QField open to observe my location, I can start moving towards my points of interest. Walking to the location, I put the antenna right above it and check the position in QField. I will activate the digitize mode, which allows me to add features to the current layer. Locking the coordinate cursor to my position allows me to add a point feature exactly where my GNSS device is right now. In the attribute table, I can fill in the attributes which I had set up in QGIS, in this case ID and name. The point coordinates will be updated automatically. I'm not finished yet, because I also want to add a photo to the feature, so I can recognize the object easier when I'm working in the office with it. So I simply use the attribute box again, add a photo, and that's it. Now that I'm finished recording all relevant objects and their attributes, I can close QField and copy the data back to my office computer. Back in QGIS, I update the GIS project with the QField Sync plugin again and observe the digitized data. So now I have all the locations which I recorded as features in my map. I recorded all manholes along the street, and I was also interested in the buildings which create a narrow gap for the street and recorded its outline edges. A couple meters away, there is a construction site on the bridge. I wanted to find out how much space it covers, since this could be relevant for costs. And in the intersection leading to the bridge, there is a street island which also might have to be changed due to the construction site, so I also saved its location. In the attribute table, there's all the information I saved to the features, such as names, photos, coordinates, and so on. Now I can combine the infield data with other relevant projects. Or in my case, I created a little map with QGIS to show the data I collected. So here you can see I put different objects into different layers and gave them different visibility. So it's good to see on the map what kind of data I collected. So what are the main advantages in combining RTK, GNSS with geographic information systems the way I just did? With QGIS and QField you can work in open source programs which are completely free to use. It's a low budget option and also works quickly to collect and digitize any kind of field data. From us at REDcatch you can get compatible tools to receive exact GNSS signals. And also use these tools to combine GIS with photogrammetric processing, which is explained in another video. At REDcatch, we provide hardware and software tools as well as training and full support for its usage. So don't hesitate to get in touch with us. Thank you for watching.